Blossom Alpaca Farm. Did I say that right?
Yes.
We are the 2U from Olive and 2U. We're going to yell at you today because we have a fan behind us. It's making a lot of noise. But we have to have the fan for the alpaca because, you know, it's kind of hot out here in Florida.
Now, wait a minute. Okay, plural. Alpaca or alpacas?
You know what? I am just now able to identify which is an alpaca and which is a llama. So don't even start confusing
me. That was one question we didn't ask.
Bam, bam, bam. This is Carolyn, and I'm Michelle, and we thank you for joining us. So if you've been watching us at all, you know that what we like to do is travel around and go to various places that have to do with fiber here in Florida. At the moment, we're restricted to Florida, but we're not always going to be restricted to Florida. Just watch. And so today we're at Sweet Blossom Alpaca Farm in Dade City, Florida. And it's just amazing. In fact, we got a really late start recording because we were playing with the alpaca and we could not tear ourselves away. So we hope you can hear us over the fan, but we definitely wanted to record here, and you might see some of the babies, well, not babies, they do have some babies, but you might see some of the alpaca coming around. They're all over there right now where you can't see, but they're adorable. Absolutely amazing.
Did you have a favorite?
Duchess might be my favorite. So, get this. Duchess is she's a pure black?
True black. She's
a true black.
A true black.
She's pregnant.
Yes.
And not only is she pregnant, she's like impending delivery. So it could happen while we're here.
That would be awesome. Would be awesome.
They said it takes like 20 minutes for the baby to be born. Why is it not that way with humans? That's what I want to know. I was in labor 24 hours.
Yeah.
20 minutes.
I was in labor a long time.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Maybe their labor's longer and it's just 20 minutes to birth it.
I don't know. She didn't act like she was in labor. She was so sweet and just loved on us and ate and then proceeded to use the bathroom. And we saw that too.
My favorite part was when she was sniffing where she had used the pot because she's got delivery coming, and she says that one of the owners, said that she'll do that when delivery's impending,
yeah.
I guess, to kind of know the signs and self-assess where she's at. And then she wanted to come over and give Carolyn some love.
What happened? None of it.
Yeah. But yeah. They're just so sweet, and they're expressive, and they're curious. When we walked up, they immediately wanted to know what was going on.
Mm-hmm.
So, totally, totally awesome.
They will spit, but we didn't get spit on.
No, they were curious and coming up to us. And they have a Kriya. A baby is called a Kriya. And they have a Kriya that is 12 days old, I think Debbie said. 11 days old?
I think so, yeah.
And is adorable. I actually liked their Facebook page, Sweet Blossom Alpaca on Facebook. And I was able to see the pictures of the Kriya when she was first born. And,
there goes Duchess again.
There goes Duchess.
She was sniffing the poop pile.
Well, okay. I'll give up having a short labor if I don't have to sniff the poo to know where I'm at. So there are some advantages to being human and not alpaca.
A few.
Just saying. I'm getting over a cold, so y'all are going to have to excuse me because I'm going to suck on these things because otherwise I'll just start coughing, and that's not a good way to do a podcast.
We won't tolerate that nonsense.
We won't tolerate that. We have some exciting stuff today, though.
We do. We have lots of exciting things.
Yeah, we do. Do you know what they are?
Well, I mean, I know what we talked about. You got surprises for me?
Well, we have a surprise for you.
That's true.
We've been talking for a long time about Olive and debuting Olive. We just had to wait until we got to the alpaca farm to pick Olive up.
Because you thought Olive was a sheep, didn't you?
You're wrong.
You did. That's right.
Olive
is not a sheep.
She is a Surrey alpaca.
Isn't she beautiful?
She's gorgeous. And she is going home with us today.
Mm-hmm.
I'll pet her. I took
her there. She feels so soft. And she's a Surrey alpaca, which is why her, is it hair or fur?
Hair. They refer to it as hair.
Okay. Why her hair, you see how it's longer and straighter. And then, and that's mostly what they have here at Sweet Blossom. Is 90, well, I don't remember. It's primarily Surrey alpaca. And then they also have Wakaya.
Wakaya.
Which I think they're adorable too, because their fur is like, poofs out. You know, like a fluffy dog. but
amazing.
Olive is a Surrey alpaca, and she's beautiful.
She is beautiful.
And I might get these numbers wrong, but I think Debbie was saying that, that the majority of the fiber out there that comes from alpaca is Wakaya,
yep,
not Surrey. So the Surrey is more rare, but it's amazing and wonderful. So we have some visitors that are coming up. They are going to be touring Sweet Blossom Alpaca today. And so you might see them or hear them. Sweet Blossom Alpaca does do tours. They do a tour and a lunch even. Homeschool groups, various kinds of groups can come and do that. And they're really knowledgeable.
Yes.
Their big thing is educating the public about alpaca. And just Debbie and Narvel, that's his name, right?
Narvel?
Are wonderful. They're great at explaining things about the alpaca. And she even set me straight. You know, I've had this long-standing thing between alpaca and llama. But it turns out, I was validated.
Yeah. It's hard to tell the
it's
difference.
It's hard to tell the difference. And it's really difficult if you don't have one next to the other for comparison. But if you have one next to the other, it's not too bad to tell. Apparently, llama have ears that are more banana-shaped. They, like, curve a little bit like a banana.
Mm-hmm.
Alpaca don't. Llama are larger than alpaca. They have two llama here that are guard llama, a male and a female. And they make a noise, a high-pitched noise, when they see something going on that should not be going on.
Yeah.
She said they're constantly scanning the perimeter, and they know what should be happening, and they're excellent guard animals. I had no idea. Who knew? It's very exciting.
I'm sorry, I'm not paying attention because I'm watching them. They were all behind us earlier, and so we set up this way, but now they've all kind of moved out that way. But she said they'll wander back in.
They'll come back in. So if you can hear us over the roar of the fan, but they have to have the fan because they have to stay cool. They're out there. It's interesting because they're cushing. Is that what it's called?
Yes.
When they sit down like a camel. And Debbie was explaining that that's an invitation. When they cush and they sit down, then you can pet on them and love on them, and they're fine with it.
Yep.
And so we got a couple pictures. We'll have to include those in the podcast. So.
Dutch, I'm sure hoping you're having your baby today. Good luck.
So, you know, there's all different personalities of these guys.
You can see that.
Yes, you can definitely see that.
And here we have the onlookers. I'm out here.
Aww. Hello.
Excuse me, where's food for me?
Right. And little Tiana. She's blue eyes. Those crystal blue eyes.
Yes.
She's deaf.
Aww.
But you would never know it.
Well, I was going to say, how do you know that she's deaf?
Well, I've done tests in the morning in the barn, and you know, she's sleeping.
That's why I was debating if I could actually do it. Oh, there you go. My turn.
That's really rich brown.
Yes. And that's what Toby is over there. Well, he's in the corner right there, that one skein of yarn, or the skeins of yarn in there, or hanks, sorry.
Okay. But it all works.
Yeah.
Yarn.
Yeah, yarn.
That's so awesome.
They're amazing.
They are.
Okay, so give me a lesson, because I stink.
at knowing the difference between an alpaca and a llama. Help set me straight finally.
All right. So this, what we have here is an alpaca.
Right.
A Surrey alpaca at that. And their fiber is a little bit softer or a lower micron count than what a llama typically carries on their body. Llamas are double their size of an alpaca in height, weight, and same kind of overall demeanor though. I haven't noticed a difference in their demeanor. So you still have your different personalities at the llamas. I can, scratch the chin of my female llama. But other times she wants nothing to do with me.
So you have a llama here?
Oh, I have two llamas.
You have two llamas.
A male guard llama.
Okay.
A protector.
I need a guard llama.
And a female guard llama.
Wow.
So they are much taller, and so they can they're constantly scanning to make sure nothing is going on that shouldn't be going on. And they're the first to alert the herd that they're part of, that there's something going on that they need to be aware of. And they alert by making a sound, a high-pitched sound. And basically everyone would just run out as a group. And because they're herds, so the larger the group, the more protected the majority are in that group.
Interesting.
Yes. Oh, it's, yeah.
So if you drive up on a group of llama or alpaca, what's the first thing you should look for to distinguish whether they're a llama or alpaca?
Oh, the first thing would be the size and shape of the ears.
Okay.
So a llama has much bigger ears, and they're kind of what we call banana shaped.
Okay.
And of course the alpacas are more pointy. And they're much smaller.
Gotcha. You have a friend, Nakria, came over.
Yes. Hey, beautiful. Hi.
So sometimes they'll come right over to you if you're squatting. Okay. Other times they won't. But she's very curious.
Yeah.
Like, what's going on over here?
But, here comes Mark. It looks like they are very curious.
Oh, yeah. So that's Helen.
Yep, that's Helen.
Who is this?
This is Zariah.
Zariah.
With the little Kriya, who's 12 days old. This is Duchess.
And she the one that's pregnant?
Yep, she's very pregnant.
And Mike is
so
today.
Sweet.
Yes, she is.
So sweet. Oh, Helen, can I have a kiss from you?
Aww. I just love it.
Was that a no?
Beautiful eyes,
You're
though.
Beautiful. Yes. Look at you. You're so cute. Are you smiling?
Yeah.
Are you smiling? Are you smiling?
So when they get sheared, we actually trim up their bangs, too.
Okay. Can you pet them without food?
Yeah, I was petting. Helen probably will let you pet her.
You'll let me pet her? Oh, you're
Sure.
You need your space, huh?
Well, and she is the type, it usually takes 10-15 minutes for her to just to observe and hear our voices, and then she'll come right over and usually she'll just push. And then you can squat or just take pictures with her,
rub
her all over. It's amazing.
It is so much fun. For hours and hours and hours. So you know that our
Can you say where it is? We're in Dade City, Florida, by the way.
Dade City, Florida.
I think I may have mentioned that.
Yeah, they've got a lot of acreage here. And they also have some donkeys. I saw a couple chickens.
And apparently they have two Angora rabbits, which
German Angora rabbits.
To see.
We haven't seen those yet. We might have to ask her to see those.
We may have to ask to see those.
They have a little shop, and they do carry alpaca yarn. They send their yarn off to be milled. We're talking a little bit about that. We might do something special. Look at what Carolyn got.
Look at that. So this is... It's 3-ply DK. It's 90% Surrey alpaca, and it's 10% mulberry silk, and it's got just a little bit. Can you see the blue and purple shine in there? Yeah, they put just a smattering of that as well. I got two hanks of this, so I'm going to do something special.
It's beautiful. And what's really neat about their yarn, too, is that, let me see for a second, if you can bear to part with it.
You must.
If I talk loud, I start to cough, and I'm trying to talk loud over the fan. Is they have the name of the animal on the tag. Unfortunately, Umeko, is that how you pronounce it?
Umeko.
She's no longer with us, she said, and she passed away. But they actually match the fiber to the animal.
Mm-hmm.
So we're gonna be talking to them a little bit about what we might do with some of their alpaca.
Yeah, it's so just beautiful.
It's gorgeous. And they have other items from Peru. Mm-hmm. And here they do rugs and socks and hats and all kinds of things. So I don't think this will be our last time here at Sweet Blossom Alpaca. And they've been amazingly welcoming.
Yes.
So we'd recommend it. If you're in the area, definitely. I'll have the link down below and you can contact them.
And if you like their Facebook page, you can get updates. Duchess, who's about to have a baby, they'll post that when it happens.
I want her to have it today.
I know. Wouldn't that be awesome?
That would be very cool.
No, she's in labor. You can stand next to her and see the baby moving.
Yeah.
Which is, that was awesome. I can't imagine comfortable, but she's seems to be fine. She was very loving and kind. Their eyes are so expressive.
Yes.
So last time, you'll remember, we were at Little Thimble Craft in Celebration, Florida, and that was a total blast. We had so much fun with Alessandra. We have some exciting things coming up there. Should we tell them about the classes?
Sure.
So we're going to be teaching a dye class, a beginning dye class, and we're going to be doing a workshop on meditative knitting that we're very, very excited about.
Super excited.
Super excited! I feel like pom-poms. Super, oh, I shouldn't show that yet. Super excited. Super excited about the classes and a couple other things coming up there. So we're very, very excited. We've got a trunk show coming up there on, is it May 19th?
Yes, May 19th. We will be there at Little Thimble Craft.
Little Thimble Craft for a trunk show, 10 to 2, I believe is our time.
Yep.
And we'll have the details on our Facebook page. Are those chickens I hear?
Yeah.
Are we sure they're chickens?
Yeah.
Okay. They're chickens. Oh, Journey's out there. Journey is a little boy alpaca. He's gray.
He didn't really want anything to do with us.
No, he was curious, but he kind of wandered off. Yeah. Anyway, so Little Thimble was awesome. You definitely need to check it out if you're in Celebration. And what did you buy at Little Thimble?
Oh, yes. Let me show you what I bought. Oh, I got the cutest little scissors. I love them. They have, she has all sorts of embroidery scissors there. But I bought a more economical pair because my budget couldn't afford some of the more expensive ones. But look at how cute that is. And it fits right into my Notions pouch. And they're little foxes. Can you see it?
I didn't know they were foxes.
Yeah, they're foxes. It's that yellow one that clues you in right there.
Cute!
But I love them. They're super sharp. And they fit right into my Notions pouch to cut my yarn.
Nice.
That, oh, and let me show you one other thing. Okay, so I have a thing for office supplies. It comes with homeschooling curriculum, office supplies, whatever. I get very excited. And she had, so there's a French company that she buys from, and I think it's pronounced Sajou. You see it down there? Yeah. Anyway, it's a store in Paris, and they have literally been around since like the 1800s, and she has all sorts of embroidery and other stuff. If you go to their website, they have other things as well. But she, so she keeps these little notebooks in there, and I always have notebooks around that I keep track of things on.
She's very detail-oriented.
Like
me, I buy notebooks and they're empty.
Which is why I handle the finances.
That's why I handle the finances. You know what? I'm not ashamed.
That's right.
Is there a receipt for that?
When we first got here today, and Narble was, we didn't know him at the time. He's walking up, and we're kind of intimidated because the fence is locked and everything, and he's walking up, and she said, I guess I should get out and go talk to him. And I said, that's right. You're our PR person.
Uh-oh. So we might have some mating going on. Oh, Journey's feeling his oats.
Interesting.
I was curious. Oh, look. There he goes.
And that's not his mama either. Is that his mom?
We won't put that. No, that's
not his mom.
That's Helen.
Yeah.
We won't put that on camera
for a while.
X-rated alpaca. Probably not what you want to see.
Yeah. Anyway.
Sorry.
So that was it. And then I bought a couple pom-pom makers, but I haven't even gotten the package open on that, so I'm not showing you that.
Slacker.
I know. I am a slacker. But anyway, she is the cutest shop.
It is. Oh, there they are. There's some back there.
Yeah. Can you see them?
No, they're not on the camera. Maybe not.
Oh, it's the lighting. Over here is too white, and so it's not showing them.
We're doing our best. You never know what you're going to get when you're out in the field doing these podcasts.
Well, there's footage.
Yeah,
you're putting
in,
so that'll be
in there.
Yeah.
So you remember?
What did you? Didn't you get something from Little Thimble?
You remember my rectangulum that still has ends that need to be woven in?
Speaking of slackers,
because I'm a slacker. You know what? I've got a good excuse. But I need
I have good excuses too. But that's what they are, is excuses.
You're just drunk.
Yes, here. Kidding, as I drink my water.
As you drink your water. So I needed buttons for my rectangulum. Remember I was tossing around what to do? So she had these little, like little buckets of buttons. Pink and green. So I got one of each. And so
hold them up to the thing. Show how well.
Camera?
Rectangulum. Look at that. Those will go perfectly, won't they?
So I have to decide if I want to alternate.
I think you should.
Or do all pink. I'm tempted to do all pink.
Yeah, the green, that's such a good match. It almost hides in there.
Yeah. I like those shiny ones.
Mm-hmm.
Might be kind of fun.
Yeah.
But she's got all these little containers of buttons, and they're all the same color, but just different hues.
Yep.
And they're not expensive at all. I mean, very inexpensive. And they're really good.
Yeah.
So that was my big find there.
Perfect.
I was very excited. And I got one other thing. I got to move Olive a little bit. I love ribbon. I have a thing for ribbon. And this is like little
what
ribbons.
Is that?
Little sewing machines and stitches and ribbon. And I thought it was pretty neat. I have no idea. Oh, and there is like a little, oh, that's a ladybug. I thought it was a sheep. It's a ladybug. Well, it has like a little outline thing. Anyway.
I'm the drunk one.
I have no idea what I'm going to do with this ribbon.
But you know, you don't have to know what you're going to do with everything that you buy.
No.
Or else
we have no yarn stash if we, you know.
And we have to have a yarn stash.
Exactly. So those were our finds at Little Thimble, but I had to restrain myself because there were lots of other things I wanted to buy. She's got amazing fabrics and all kinds of things, but we're going to be spending quite a bit of time there. So we're very, very excited about that. So Mother's Day is coming up. Talking about that faster than we thought it was.
Yeah. What are y'all doing for? Are you doing? Do you have anything planned yet?
No. Well, we are. As if you've been following anything, you know that my mother's house is under contract. It closes on the 15th of May. That's what we're anticipating. And she's going into an assisted living facility. And wow, it's been busy trying to. Get everything ready for that and cleaning out the house and doing all that. So I haven't even had time to think about Mother's Day. And it's coming up on the 13th.
I think it's the 13th, yeah.
13th. So I need to come up with something quick, but I'm spending a lot of time with my mom. Speaking of which, as we've been cleaning, you know, this week we brought home, last weekend I brought home her china. She wanted me to have her china and her crystal that she got in Germany. And so we brought that home yesterday. Got it all put away and everything. But in the middle of cleaning everything out and kind of reminiscing about our families,
where'd it go? You lost it again, didn't you?
I lost it again?
Yeah. She can't.
Where'd it go? Here it is. So there was this amazing little spoon that I found, and it's so appropriate. So my mom used to have these friends who were from Peru. I don't know if you can see it. And they brought back this spoon from Peru. It's silver. It's very intricate, and that is an alpaca on the top. Do you see that? It's an alpaca.
Yeah, you can see.
It's beautiful. I'll take a better picture of it and have
it. Yeah, you need to.
But it just, it's so intricate. It's got the scroll work and the time that it must have taken to create that spoon. It's handcrafted.
Yeah.
And so I've got to take it home and clean it up. But that was in my mother's thing. And
that's
she was so excited
awesome.
To give it to me, and because of the connection. And I might have to frame it. I'm thinking that would look really nice once it's cleaned up. Put it on a mat and frame it, maybe with some yarn and
some yarn pictures too.
Yeah. So I'm very excited about that. So that's my mother's story. So that's what we're in the midst of. So hopefully she'll be settled. In about a month or so.
That'll
I mean, it's going to take some time. She'll be 12 minutes away from me, which I'm very excited about, but it's pretty nerve-wracking, I have to admit. I've not been able to spend as much time online responding to everybody as usual because of just the time that it's taking. So,
You're doing good.
I'm trying. My nephew said to me yesterday, wow, it must be a big relief for mom to have the house off her shoulders and stuff, and I said, yeah, and it's all coming squarely on my shoulders, so... starting to feel the gravity of it, but I'm excited about what it means for us going forward and the time I'll be able to spend with her. She's 86. She'll be 87 in September. She tells everybody she's 87. And as soon as she turns 87, she'll tell everybody she's 88. She's done this forever, unlike most women. So what about your mom? What are your plans?
We haven't made any yet. You know, I had thought I wanted to knit her something, but I've been busy knitting on my sweater, selfishly. And, well, plus the pattern that I had, it wasn't going to work with the yarn I wanted to use. So anyway, I can't knit something up in 2 weeks because I can't handle the stress. I can't. And I realized something with this sweater because I was trying to finish it for today. I am like one of those lazy Sunday afternoon drivers with knitting. I'm telling you what, I'll be knitting along and, oh, did somebody just text me? Or, you know, oh, what was that on the podcast? Let me rewind that. And then I'll sit there watching it for a few minutes. And I think, like, if I want to knit fast, it has to be a conscious decision. Okay, move faster. Otherwise, I'm just,
You know, that's interesting that you say that. I saw something the other day about what technology is doing to our brains and how it's rewired us to some degree to fragment our attention.
I can see that.
Because I do the same thing. I'll be knitting and I have to check Facebook or I have to pick up my phone and I struggle with that, and it's a byproduct of technology.
It's terrible. I need to cut that out.
I've been working on it.
Yeah. Well, that's good. I'm going to start doing that more. And I do during the day, I guess, when we homeschool. I'll set my phone aside and have it on silent. But I don't know. Too many times when I'm knitting. And even if I don't, it's not just my phone. It's just other things. I don't know. I just notice that I'm distracted easily. And I just kind of am I don't know.
I got to get you knitting meditatively.
Apparently something. I don't know.
You can focus your attention on that project. That's important.
All right.
So what else about your mom, though? You don't have plans for Mother's Day, so you got to get on that. Is that on a list somewhere?
No.
That should be on a list somewhere. Deal with mother for Mother's Day.
You make it sound like a chore.
No, I don't mean it like that.
Do we want to talk about the project bags?
Talk about project
bags. That my
mom
makes? Okay, so here's the deal with the project bags. So Michelle started the project bags. So she's the one who got us going on them. And we've talked about these before, right? But my mom now makes them because she, why does she do it for us? She's a better sewer.
She is. She sews better than I do.
Than we are. And she just happens to have the time. Plus, she's at my house. She splits her time between my house and my sister's house. And so, and she's one of those people that, I think it's something to do with that generation. Like, she feels guilty if she sits and rests too much. And like this last week when she was here, she had some project bags to finish. I don't either. I have no problem setting aside chores and not cleaning my house for the day because I want to read and finish a book, or I have a project I'm knitting
on. I saw something on Facebook yesterday. It said, when I learned how to knit, I forgot how to clean.
Yes. But I've always been that way. Like, I don't have a problem when I know when my body needs to take a day off from doing stuff. She's not wired that way. So anyway, she is very productive. And I'm not saying I'm lazy because I'm busy dyeing yarn. It's not.
No, I'm just kidding. She really doesn't drink that much. Truly.
I know, you would think that I do. But anyway, we will have, they're not on the website yet, are they?
Some of them are.
These will be put on the website by the time this podcast airs. So
she's glaring at me.
These are on the website. We have two sizes. So we have, this is the little lamb. We've always called that. This is a pretty much a one hang project bag.
Look at that print. I love that.
I know. It
and it has the leather Olive and 2U logo tag on it.
Yep. So these, do you want to pull one out? Because, so what she does, take that one out.
If I can get the bag open. We have a very vocal chicken on that.
Yeah,
oh,
we do.
Look at the baby.
Is that Sakura?
Yes.
I think that's Sakura.
That's not Helen, that's Sakura.
Saying hi to us. Okay, so here's the deal. So what do you call this fabric, Michelle, that we use up here?
It's like a canvas.
A canvas.
So it's got a good body weight to it, so it holds its shape pretty well.
But she also does attach interfacing to it. So you can stand it up.
Stands up straight.
Yep, stands up. I don't know.
And some have pockets and some do not.
Yeah, most of them at this point, she's putting pockets on all of them. The yarn is not good for, it's not a stable.
It doesn't have anything in it, so it's not standing up.
But then you can see the inside. Most of them have a neutral color on the inside and they have pockets.
So it's light so you can see what's inside. You're not, you know, around in the dark. And
yeah, that's the purpose for that. But it's also, I mean, if you want it to be, it does scrunch. It's not like totally.
Yeah,
you know,
stiff.
Stiff, but yeah. So then it has, of course, our cute little label, our logo, which I think you've already shown that in the past. But we also now have a Two Hank project bag, which we just named. I'm just going to tell you that.
We just named Michelle.
Yeah. We have a name for these, and on the fly, because she's good like that.
This is the double U. Get it? The double U.
That's right.
E-W-E.
So, and I think you could easily put three.
Oh, yeah. We call it the double U because you could put two skeins, but yeah, three. That has the pocket inside.
In
I don't know if I can. I'm not a good Vanna.
Yeah.
You see there's a pocket in there?
Yeah.
And again, it's like, I love this fabric. This is one of my favorite fabrics. And it's got the little leather thing here so that you can put a carabiner on it if you like, with keys, and then all in the 2U tag. It's pretty awesome. I might have to take this one. I want them all.
I know. I want one of every color.
Me too. And we've got lots of different. Let me show some of the fabrics.
Which they'll be shown individually, so you'll see the fabrics on the website that you want.
So this one's got that summer stripe.
Yep.
This is a blue and green, which is really nice.
This is one of my new favorites. This colorway.
And I like this one. That's a really fun print. So very fun.
Yeah.
Very fun little project bags. And we've got plenty of project bags.
Yes, we do.
So the little lamb is the small one. The W is the one for two or probably three skeins of yarn. Absolutely. And your mom does a great, great job on those.
She is. She's so good.
So I'm very, very excited about that.
All right. What's next?
The giveaway.
Oh, we have a giveaway.
We're trying to stay on topic. Yeah. So we have a list today that we're trying to stay on topic.
Yeah, we don't always have.
Well, we do it on the fly. We're on the fly kind of people. Well, I am. More so than her.
But it works, right?
It works, that's right.
You're watching,
it works. So you'll remember from our last podcast, because of course you watched it all the way through. This is the yarn. This is Prospector from Bigfoot Fibers. Sheila does a great job with her dyeing, and we love her yarn, and she's very sweet. She's out in Oklahoma, and so she sent us some yarn, and this is the giveaway. So Carolyn has done her heavily mathematically precise.
Yeah, I
detail-oriented.
I tracked all their entries. So if you remember, the requirements were that you needed to subscribe if you hadn't already and tell us so, and what you liked about our podcast, or if there's something you thought we should add or do differently.
What you don't like.
And then what's not to like.
What's not to like.
And then also you could increase your entries by posting your finished objects in the 18 and 2018 thread.
We love looking.
Oh my gosh, and we have a lot of sock knitters, so we've been talking, we're going to do something for socks.
Yeah.
We'll
Eventually. I've got to finish my socks. I still have socks on the needles. But I've been busy.
Yes.
What can I say?
Excuses again. But if you have an idea, let us know what you think we should do for socks.
Do you knit socks? Tell us.
A lot of them do. Well, so what I did was I got all their names down and how many entries they had. And then I literally put the names on paper, cut them up, and drew them out of a hat. Well, a box.
More specific. Joking.
Just more specific.
Yarn is a weapon.
It could be.
Isn't it? It's very soft.
All right. Do you want to tell who the winner is?
Drum roll.
I can't do a drum roll. I'll do dun dun dun.
Who is it?
So her Ravelry name is Apple Juice. And her real name is Michelle. She lives in St. John's, Florida. How fun is that, that she actually lives
local.
In Florida? I know.
Not that that matters. Everybody had a fair chance.
We promise. But anyway, so Michelle, Apple Juice.
I love that name.
Me too.
You need to message us and give us your address, and we will send you this fabulous
yarn.
Yarn.
It's
all
yay!
Yours.
Congratulations!
Yay.
But you got to show us what you make with it.
That's right. That's
we'll be
the only requirement.
To see. She's pretty prolific too with her knitting, I think.
She is. Yeah.
Puts us to shame.
I know. And she's the one that did some really cute. Oh, how did she describe them? It looked like a little flower or something, a doll in a.
Oh
anyway,
yeah.
I don't remember what it's called.
They were adorable.
Yeah.
They're not amigurumi, are they?
I don't think it's called that.
Is that crochet?
No.
You can do amigurumi knitting?
I'm pretty sure.
Okay.
I don't know, what is that? Is that a specific type of?
It's like, you know, little creatures and stuff.
So it has to be like a creature? It can't just be any small object?
I don't know. Don't ask me questions I don't know the answer to. That's
okay.
Not fair.
I don't think that. Don't make me look stupid. I mean, she may do some of that, but I don't think that. We do have some people in.
Pronouncing that name right. Is it amigurumi?
I don't even know how to pronounce it. I thought it was amiguri or something.
I'm feeling kind of bumbly today.
I am too. It's the heat. Yeah.
It's
warm here in Florida now.
Okay. Yay, we're very excited. And
yes.
While we're talking about yarn before we go on, I just want to mention the Yarn Lounge.
Yes.
We didn't have that on our list, but we needed to talk about it. We're having so much fun with this. So, I think I mentioned on the last podcast that we'd opened up tickets.
Mm-hmm.
So the tickets are totally free, but we ask that you grab them because it gives us an idea about what the attendance is going to be. And they're going. We're up over, we're close to 90 now. Close to 90 tickets that have gone out, and it's early. We're not even technically in May yet,
yep.
And it's on June 9th at Deadly Sins Brewing in Winter Park, Florida from 2 until 7. You bring your spinning, knitting, weaving, or crochet project.
Mm-hmm.
Hang out with other fiber crafters and do your craft. We're going to have demonstrations. We have Brianna from Infinity Crochet who's going to be coming and doing an Infinity Crochet demonstration. We're going to have a yarn market with Casual Fashion Queen, Twin Mommy Creations, String Theory Colorworks, and us. The four of us will have a yarn market so you can come and squeeze our lovelies and purchase them and our other items. There'll be food trucks or food truck. We're not sure yet which. It's plural. And we're super excited about it. We are super excited about it because there's starting to be some buzz about it. And we're hoping to make these potentially quarterly events. So the more people that come out and support it, the more we'll be able to determine whether or not it's something that's sustainable. But it goes back to our mission and idea of building up the local fiber community. And you know, we met some really neat people a few weeks ago who are kind of dovetailing to that too. Nomadic Knits.
Mm-hmm.
Becky and Melissa from Nomadic Knits, you'll definitely want to check out their blog. They came down and interviewed us, spent some time with us, and we gave them some yarn, and they're working on a pattern. And they're interested, their concept for Nomadic Knits is traveling to different parts of the country and featuring the various knits that are appropriate for that area, climate-wise and that
mm-hmm.
sort of thing. So that's pretty neat. That's a very distinct thing. So we're very excited about what we're doing with Nomadic Knits. They also talked to Caitlin with String Theory Colorworks with her self-striping yarn. So it's neat that there were two of us in the same area. And they talked to other people locally as well. But within our immediate sphere, it was us and Caitlin. And we're so pleased with them.
Yeah.
They're
now their
people.
Website is not just nomadicknits.com. It's like Nomadic Knits R Us, I believe.
Okay.
It was something a little funny. Because if you just put in Nomadic Knits, something else comes
up. I'll
put
the link in the show notes.
There you go.
So it'll be there, but you definitely want to check them out on Instagram as well. They've got neat pictures all the time. So they are a lot of fun. All right.
So, show us. Do you want to talk about, since we're talking about Nomadic Knits, you want to talk about Melissa's pattern that you're
going
to do? Might as well talk about that now.
Well, we think I'm going to do it.
Well, we hope. So, you want to tell how we got the pattern?
So we did a picture recently of our Chesterton yarn. Now, if you haven't caught on yet, our yarns are all, not the colorways, but the yarns themselves are named after authors. Have we talked about that before?
I don't remember.
I think maybe we did when
mention that crop.
So I was featuring, we were featuring our Chesterton yarn the other day, which is a bulky weight yarn, or super bulky. And this is Chesterton. It's nice and soft and wunderbar. And this is Smokescreen Colorway. And I really like this and wanted to knit it up. So I was featuring it, and Melissa sent us a pattern and said, hey, I have this pattern that I designed and it would be awesome for that yarn. So we looked at it and said, I'm gonna knit it up. So here it is. It's called, what's the other name?
My Big Fat Faded Sweater.
Woohoo!
I love it.
So I'm gonna do a fade, and I'm gonna use these three colors. And I think I've decided I'm gonna do them in that order. I'm gonna start at the top with the Smokescreen. And then I'm going to go secondly with a little bit, and then I'm going to end with a little bubbly. So those three colors on the pattern. So I'm like really excited about that. Melissa, thank you so much. That was so kind of you. And when I told her thank you, she said, I like to spread a little pattern love occasionally. So that was an unexpected surprise. We need to pay that forward to somebody else somehow, some way.
Yeah.
Because it's
how you
want
to do it.
Paying it. I don't know. We'll have to talk about it later.
All right.
Don't commit me to anything just yet.
Well, you brought it up.
I know I did. I did.
Well, if you're interested, and she has other designs, and it's her name is Melissa Kemmerer, and it's Melissa Kemmerer Designs on Ravelry.
And
so check
so
her
sweet.
Stuff out. She is the sweetest thing ever.
She's very sweet. She's got a great Instagram as well.
Yep.
So you'll want to follow her also. Show us your
fade. So speaking of fades, tell us all. You guys have all seen this. I really had hoped to be done with this by today, but I just don't knit well under pressure. I don't. So I am literally four rows away from binding off this stupid sleeve, just so you know.
Nice sleeve. Talk nice to it. Like
Yes, nice sleeve. I have learned so much off of this project. I cannot even tell you.
That's the point.
So, just so you know, I bought these little, they're from Chowgu. I said it right this time. Chowgu. What does
Crafty
it mean again?
Crafty Lady.
Crafty Lady. I can never remember that.
Crafty Lady.
I keep wanting to say Happy Knitter. Anyway,
it's
and
Chinese,
I love, you know,
without.
That's true. You know, I love Chowgu. But these are their 9-inch.
You jumped on the 9-inch bandwagon.
Well, I'll tell you why I did it. Because I found them cheap on Amazon. Literally less than $10.
Wait, say that louder. They can't hear you over the fan. You found them cheap on
they
Amazon?
Were inexpensive on Amazon.
That's why she handles the money.
But I got to tell you what. When I put these, and I'm doing the cuff, and when I put those stitches on here, it was like putting on a pair of clown shoes and trying to go out for a run. I am not kidding you. I apparently hold my needles like way back here because it just wasn't working. I mean, like, look, you have to. So I can see why people don't maybe like these for socks.
But
I am getting more accustomed to them.
Like I told you to do.
Well, I did buy 10-inch for socks, which I haven't cast on yet, and I'm sure I will like those better.
Because the working needle
is longer. Yeah, because I keep my hand kept falling off the thing, and I'm like trying to. Yeah. Anyway, but I think I'm getting more accustomed
to what not to do.
I am getting more accustomed to it. By the time I'm done with these four rows and binding off, maybe I'll have fallen in love. I don't know. But anyway.
What size are the needles?
They're size 4.
I thought you told me you needed size 6s.
Thanks a lot. That was the other thing.
I'm confused.
Well, okay, so here's the thing. When I started this sleeve, I was like, man, because somebody had recommended get a smaller needle. And they had said a 16-inch, and I was like, I just think that would still be too big for a sleeve. So I decided I'm going to go order a short 9 or 10-inch if I can find one that I can get on Amazon so I get it within 2 days.
You're a little bit sassy independent lady.
Inexpensive. So I quickly went on, and because, see, I think at the time I was doing the cuff on the other sleeve. So this pattern calls for you have a larger size needle and a smaller. Your collar, and your cuffs, you get due in the smaller size. So when I was ordering the needle, I was actually knitting the cuff And so I guess I had that on my brain. So I ended up buying a size 4, and when it came in, I was like, oh man.
That fragmented attention.
Yeah. So, but I did, you know what I ended up, I had a smaller, I think I had a 16 inch, which is what was recommended to me. I found it in my needles. And so I ended up using it, and so it actually worked very well on the sleeve until I got down to the cuff. By then I was having to magic loop it because I had decreased enough. It was just too big. So I finally was able to use the size 4, which is what I had accidentally ordered. So anyway, yeah.
Thank you for sharing your saga with us.
Yeah. But at least...
So you're 4 rows from binding off?
I am 4 rows from binding off. Oh, and I have to tell you, so that leads me to this. This is a book that I found and I love. Okay, because here's the thing. So, you know how you're the same as me.
Well,
and I'm sure a lot of you
in
are.
Some things, not
in
everything.
In this
I'm
way,
I'm not strong.
In this way, we go on YouTube. We find videos. Like, you know, when I first needed to pick up stitches for the underarm, I didn't quite understand how it was written. So I went and watched a quick video, and then I was like, oh, that totally makes sense, just because I'm visual, I need to see it. However, there on the bind off, I'm doing the Jenny Super Stretchy bind off, and for some reason, you know, I guess once you maybe get to a certain point, when I was a complete newbie, I needed the video to show me everything. But now that I know more,
fast forward to you,
yes,
right where you need
I'm
it.
I'm like, oh, I don't need to hear that. I don't need to hear that. And so,
don't set it up. Just show me how to do
yes,
it.
Yes, I don't need to see that. But I understand that some people do. So one of the things that I have now come to appreciate. So this book is called Cast On, Bind Off, and it's by Leslie Ann Bestor. I'd not heard of her before, but she does have some other books on Amazon as well. I like this because she has pictures of everything, and so I can, well, I was going to find, where's the one of Jenny's Super Stretchy, because that's the one I used. Somehow all my pages got turned.
Uh-oh.
I know what page it's on, though. I'm like, that's not right either. Okay, that's, I lost my page. But anyway, so she shows you, oh, I know, it's all these different cast-ons and bind-offs. So anyway, but she literally will, she gives you good written instructions and then shows you picture by picture, which if you're visual like me, that's super helpful. And I like this better than videos on some things because I can just go quickly to, yeah, I know that part, and I can, you know, find the directions that I need.
I like that it's spiral bound, so
yes,
you can play flat. That's
absolutely
nice. I love books like that.
Yeah. So anyway, if you're interested and you want to find it, it's on our favorite things page. Check
our
it out.
Our favorite things.
Yeah. She's got a ton. She's got cast-ons in here and bind-offs. So that's where I figured out my Jenny's Super Stretchy, you know, after my last incident with the dog sweater that was too tight.
But you know, you learn.
That's right.
That's the whole thing.
And I have learned so much.
It's like what we were talking about you just have to keep doing things until you learn that 10,000 hours.
Yep.
Makes
that's
all
right.
The difference. So...
quite a few hours this weekend already.
So I want to ask you a question about that. Do your sleeves match?
No. Okay. So, and I'll show this when I finish it again.
I wasn't sure. Where's
so, yeah. So if you look.
Because we're all about being funky and quirky here at Olive and 2U.
And I'm telling you what, if I had over to do with, I would have totally done the sleeves differently. I would have run this dark purple up here halfway down the sleeve because I think that would have looked cool. This one over here needs some work, but it's because I haven't woven in the ends. But yeah, so you see how over there I went from my Riga to Sunset to Sunrise, and then Yams is the bigger part down at the bottom. Well, I almost ran out of that, and I wasn't going to see Michelle, and she has the other hank of Yams. So
see, she does the money, but I hold the yarn. So you tell me which you would rather do.
Yeah, but I dye the yarn, so
that's true. Okay. Fair enough.
I get it first.
Little Missy.
So anyway, you see I did a big old section of the Sunset right in there, and then now I'm not even going to do Yams. I do have some Yams left, but I didn't want to fade again, so I'm just finishing it off with the Sunrise, and I think it looks cool. I like
we're
it
we're just funky and quirky like
that's
that.
Right.
So, I love it.
Yep.
I you know, I was at home and I had a hank of Sunrise next to a hank of Pot of Pentas,
yeah,
and it looks awesome together. Those two colors look really
nice.
Well together.
I
So that might be something for later. She does dye the yarn. We sold out of Super Excited like really, really fast last week.
Yeah, we did. I know. That was awesome. Sorry, my
We donated some for Yarno, our Exquisite Yarn and Fiber Community. And people really liked it. So we sold out quickly. So we've got more Super Excited in the shop. Very limited quantity. What do we have? Four hanks this time?
Eight.
Eight. Oh, well, okay.
Limited quantity. I only had a couple of days, so.
Eight hanks of it. And it is Super Excited. It's speckled with purple, that fluorescent pink and orange, and it's got some coral and yellows in there. It is awesome. So, well, it's eight hanks. I might take one or two myself. I haven't decided yet. I'm still thinking about doing the Stephen West Starburst shawl.
Oh, that would go good with some of our minis.
Yeah, the key lime pie.
And the sunshine yellow.
Yep. Exactly. So I'm definitely thinking about doing that. I know. But then
first you have to do the faded sweater.
The projects are stacking up.
Yes, they are.
And then wanted to talk about this yarn today too. This is also one of my favorites. I can't make up my mind because I love it all.
I know.
So this is Wolf. This is our Wolf yarn, which is 70% gray alpaca, 20% silk, and 10% cashmere, and it is so soft.
It is.
So soft. And I love these colors. Look at these colors together.
I know.
Is that not beautiful?
I love it.
I'm still thinking of doing another rectangulum in this silver gray. It works with my gray hair. That's what I think. You gotta work with what you got. It works with it, but I love those colors together.
Yeah.
Especially, I like the red, but I really like, that's sacrificium. Sacrificium. But I love these two colors together.
Mm-hmm. Those look good.
I think that works with my coloring.
Denim Dusha.
That's it. That's what it is. So what do you, alpaca yarn. But we may be doing some other alpaca things soon.
We may.
Because we have local alpaca people.
Yeah.
And that is very, very exciting.
All right, are we sticking to our list here? I'm checking. Oh, you have to talk about your stickers.
My stickers!
Where did you find those, by the way?
Well, I ran in Michael's the other day to get something for the house, a little project that I'm doing. And I happened to go down the scrapbook aisle. Remember back in the day when we used a scrapbook?
Yeah, that was when we really bonded. What was that? Was that Friday nights we did that, or was that...
Friday nights into Saturday sometime. We would do
scrapbook, and we would always order pizza.
Do you remember what we ordered? Pepperoni, mushroom, black olive, thin crust from Pizza Hut.
Yes. We talked about this before. You guys are probably like, really? Don't tell me anything
else. Is there anything else? Anyway, I went down the scrapbook aisle just really quickly, and I found these really cute alpaca stickers. Well, they could be llamas, but...
No, Debbie said
they're alpaca.
They can definitely, and
aren't they
in
cute?
Peru, they dress up their alpaca, right?
They do.
They give them like...
Well, they put these things across their backs, because they're pack animals.
Yes.
Well, the llama.
The llama is. Oh, maybe that's llama then.
Well,
no.
She said they do it with the alpaca too.
Yeah.
She said they're very interchangeable.
So I did have that right. Yeah.
But aren't they neat looking?
That's cool.
I love my stickers.
Yeah.
I have no idea what I'm going to do with them.
Oh, can I show you what I got?
Oh, yeah! We almost forgot.
I forgot about it. Okay, so...
These are so cute.
I know. As you know, I homeschool my kids, so as part of that, we have a community group that is a part of the curriculum that we use, our main curriculum. So I tutor a class for 2 hours every week. But we only meet so many weeks out of the year, and it's done now. So we had our end of year celebration last night, and one of the sweet families that I have enjoyed so much this year gave me a tutor gift, and they gave me some other things too. But this was like the highlight. Unpacking this was like the highlight of my evening, because look, it says knitting girl, and she's knitting, and that green, it has texture to it. Like, do you see that?
Yep. It's got fuzzies on it.
I just love it. I don't even know where she got it from. It's called The Girls, celebrating personal passions and favorite pastimes of women everywhere.
We need to look for those. We need to put those on favorite things if we can find them.
That would be awesome.
Yeah.
I just love them.
They are too cute.
Yeah. So when I get home tonight, I'm going to
put your socks on.
Put my socks on.
Put your feet up.
Put my feet up. That's right.
Yay!
Finish that darn sweater.
That darn sweater.
It should have been done today.
She was cussing. Probably because she was drunk.
Oh, you have not seen me cuss.
I'm going to be in so much trouble. So much trouble.
That's right. I'm driving, so guess where she's going to end up?
Can I be in the alpaca house? So the dog house?
Yeah.
I love the alpaca. It's all about alpaca today. So Debbie said when they go away, they have a house sitter who comes, excuse me, and takes care of the alpaca. We volunteered to be trained. We'll be house sitters.
Let us know.
For the alpaca, we'll definitely come over. One of them's chewing. I love the way they chew.
Yeah.
With their little mouths.
Yeah.
I'll try not to impersonate it. Nobody wants to see me do that.
So apparently they're in the, it has a funny name, but it sounds like camel. The camel of that species.
You are bold to start talking about that because I don't remember the name.
Well, you talk about how they eat. It reminds me of how I've seen
camels
eating at the zoo with their teeth sticking out. And so because they have their feet, I don't know about camels, but alpaca have bottom teeth, but on the top it's just gums. And so they were eating out of our hands, and you can feel their teeth like hitting your hand, but they weren't
trying
to bite you.
They scooped the food up out of your hand. Yeah, it made it very safe because they can't bite you. Really, they've got those funky teeth, but they just use it to scoop.
Yeah.
So yeah, and you can feel their soft little noses on your palm. I'm in love with them.
I know, but you know it's interesting. She said a lot of people think, oh, they're like dogs. You can just have them as pets, but they're not. Their personality is much more like a cat, and she's right. If they're not in the mood to be pet, or you know whatever,
it's not happening.
No, it's not happening. You better not force
that photo opportunity. So they have Johnny. Wasn't
Smiley.
Johnny? Johnny Salama.
Yeah.
Smiley. Johnny Llama, get it?
Yeah.
Johnny Llama. They're almost as good as us with the puns.
That's funny.
That's hysterical. Anyway, what was the name of the one that was giving
Smiley.
You Smiley. Smiley. So you go up to the fence in the barn, and she calls him over. Debbie calls him over, and he comes right up, and he gives kisses, and he gave Carolyn a kiss, but she chickened out.
Well, he was coming up to me, and it kind of...
Because that's how you give a kiss.
Well, you know, first of all, Duchess was over there smelling the poop pile and then came up to me. So I'm a little wary of, you know, I don't let
Where's
Samantha...
Where's that nose been?
When Samantha goes up and sniffs Lucy's hind end, I'm like, back it up. I don't want your nose near me. So anyway, when he came up, he was like, I mean, he was coming in for a kiss. And so at the last minute, I gave him my cheek. And so then he kissed
you
me on the cheek.
Him.
But then he walked off and he would not come back.
He would not come back. I tried. I would not spurt him, but she did. Probably because she was drunk. No. I'm just kidding. I'll stop it. Okay. I'm beating a dead horse. Dead alpaca. No! No dead alpacas.
No
dead alpacas.
Although the way they lay out in the sun, it looks like they're dead.
They lay on their sides in the sun, and they're just, that's how they absorb vitamin D. Is that what she said?
That's what she said. Through their belly, that's where there's the least amount of fuzz.
And they look like they're dead. Oh, look at the little Kriya over by the fence. They're just so cute.
Yeah, and in the footage, you'll see the how there's not a lot. Like Olive, she has a lot of her hair still. That's because she hadn't been shorn, whereas these guys have just been freshly shorn, so they don't have a lot of hair on
them. Right. And she ships the fiber off to either a local mill here in Florida or one in Ohio to have it processed.
Yeah.
And so I'm very excited about that and about the possibilities.
Yes.
So, you know us, we're full of ideas. We've always got stuff going on. So it's exciting. All right, just a reminder, super excited back in the shop. We still have wrist rulers. We just got another order a little while back. So plenty of wrist rulers to go. And all kinds of goodies. Thank you so much. Be sure to follow us and like us on Facebook and Instagram. We do a lot of things there, our Ravelry group. And you'll want to continue watching the podcast for more yarn giveaways. We have more coming up soon.
Yep.
So thanks so much for everything.
Bye, guys.
Bye, guys.